ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहैः ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम वसुदेव वसुतम देवम कंसचाणूरमर्दनम देवकी परमानंदम कृष्णम वंदे जगद्गुरुम कृष्णम वंदे जगद्गुरुम इफ एवरीबॉडी कैन चेक देयर म्यूट एंड अनम्यूट इट विल बी ग्रेट So, looks like we finished 17. We are on 18. And basically, we had talked about, we are in the topic of Yajna Spirit. Krishna Bhagavan is saying that everybody has to do work. And best way to do work is Yajna Spirit because that takes you to the highest. That's the whole idea in just a couple words. And then one doubt that had come in Arjun's mind, somebody has to do this karma yoga rest of their life. Is there any break from it? And the previous verse he said, Krishna Bhagavan said, yes, there is one exception. If you become self-realized. But the irony is that the self-realized person also doesn't sit around because he has a different motivation. That's all it is. His motivation is, joy, happiness, trying to help people. Whereas we have to do it because, we are on the path. So we have to understand what duty is and do it as a duty. And we also live in the world. We transact with the world back and forth. So give and take. So we are taking so much from the society. That's why we are doing it. So that's the whole idea. So that last verse was, the English translation was, but the man who rejoices only in the self, who is satisfied with the self, who is content in the self alone, for him verily there is nothing to be done. So that's what we did, the whole thing, and what we talked about, satisfaction, contentment and all that, we did that. Along the same lines, Krishna Bhagavan gives one more logic why this self-realized person does not fall into that category of worldly duties. So that's where we are. And that is verse 18. And it is, so everybody has verse 18 in Bhagavad Gita. Okay, Sneha ka mute nahi hai. Baki sab ka mute hai. Yeah. That's where the noise is coming. Let's see if I can mute it. Yeah, okay. नैव तस्य कृते नाथ नाकृते नेह कश्चन न चास्य सर्वभूतेषु कश्चिदर्थव्यपाश्रयः सो न इज नॉट एव इज इवन तस्य ऑफ हिम कृतेन बाय एक्शन अर्थ कंसर्न न इज नॉट अकृतेन बाय एक्शन नॉट डन सो या तो एक्शन करना या नहीं करना इह हियर कश्चन एनी न इज नॉट च इज एंड अस्य इज ऑफ दिस मैन सर्वभूतेषु इन ऑल बीइंग्स कश्चित इज एनी अर्थ व्यपाश्रय डिपेंडिंग फॉर एनी ऑब्जेक्ट सो ये अर्थ व्यपाश्रय दिस ऑल्सो टू वर्ड्स है अर्थ बोलते हैं ना काम आई मीन धर्म अर्थ काम मोक्ष अर्थ मीन्स गेटिंग समथिंग लाइक धन बोलो और इमोशनल थिंग्स जस्ट अक्वायरिंग समथिंग दोज आर अर्थ एंड आश्रय मीन्स डिपेंडेंसी इट्स एवरीबडी नोज दैट हिंदी का वर्ड आश्रय सो व्हाट इट इज दैट अर्जुन wanted to run away, right, in the beginning. So Krishna Bhagwan is convincing him that he must fight the war because that is his duty. And then he's telling that why we need to do the duty, the whole cycle of, you know, the chakra, you know, how it coming from the Bhagwan, and then, you know, karma, and then yagna, and from a yagna you get rain. Rain is like productivity, and from productivity you get prosperity. So we all need to help in that chakra. It's like if we are taking something, we got to give something back. Basically, that's the whole idea. So when Arjun wanted to run away, Krishna said, no, you got to do your duty. So now then Arjun asked, right, is there any exception to the rule? And he said, yes, there is, if you become self-realized. But then Krishna Bhagwan is telling Arjun, in my opinion, you're not self-realized. And then we all are representative of Arjun, you know. So in my arrogance, I might think, oh, I got it, everything. You know? No, I don't, you know. So that's why I need to continue. So then he gives a logic, and now he's giving in a logic that, look, in this verse he's saying, why does the self-realized person doesn't have a duty? Because he is not depending on anybody. He's not depending on anything. He is happy in himself completely. You know how those sadhus live on the Himalayas? They're not taking anything from society. So they have no obligation towards society. They might do something for them, for sure, but they're not obligated. So that's where this is coming from, because this verse is actually saying that for him, there is no interest in something to do, and there is no loss if he doesn't do it. You know, that's what, for his personal gain. And also the second aspect of it is that he does not depend on any being, basically. But being may, you can also say that he doesn't depend on any person, or doesn't depend on any object, like that. Because see, if we live in the household, we depend on each other. Right now, I'm depending a big time on my family to help me. So we are dependent. So when my time comes, I gotta help them. You know, so like that, we are dependent, like, over here. I'm just giving an example. Why this person is not dependent? Because he is not in body consciousness. That's why. That's the main thing. Because if you just objectively look at it, it may not look very kosher. But there is some deeper meaning always, right? So we are still in body consciousness, you know, but they are above it. They live in that self, and, you know, they see themselves as that self, and they see the whole world as self. And that's why they always revel in it. And that's why they are not dependent. They kind of know that this world is like a dream, and we just kind of know. They not only know, but they live it. I think that's the difference. We know it intellectually, but we still don't. We have not crossed that bridge yet, you know, of completely going over. Could it be also
that they don't have any more desires because they see the oneness? Also?
Yes, yes.
So if they don't have desires, there's no action because they're not prompted to do anything.
Exactly like that. So these, you know, this whole concept is such, you can catch it from whichever angle you want. And what your angle is a very potent one too, that, hey, he has no desire because he got everything. So for no desire, then no action, because our actions are prompted by desire. But so now Krishna Bhagwan is only saying that what you do is you purify your mind. So then you will also have less and less and less desires. And then one day we will reach. True. Okay. So that's what this whole concept is. So before we read, any other point or any other question?
Making sure you have recording on.
Yes, I do. I should keep the phone a little closer.
Point I had while
say that
I
again?
Read about this Vivekananda.
Mm-hmm.
Because he died very young.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason he died very young, he has come there to do an assignment.
Mm-hmm.
And he finished that and then he went.
True. And now that you said, it is so interesting. My sister sent me a link of a movie called Vivekananda Ki Atmakatha, and it was on YouTube. And if any of you, you know, and then it's an English version is there too. And exactly what you said, that he was like, in the beginning, just like any teenager, but he had a very strong quest inside for God. But, and then when Ramakrishna Paramahans told him, yes, I have seen God and I can show you, that's when he started coming. But Ramakrishna recognized him more than he recognized himself. Ramakrishna kept saying, you know, you have a big purpose. He told him, you are like a... I think somebody's thing is... Uma's thing is not muted. Okay. So he told him that I want you to... Don't go for You know what he told him? I was shocked. He said, don't even go for self-realization. Don't become selfish. You are a big banyan tree that a lot of people are going to take shade under. That's what his guru told him. You know, he's saying that you should not have a desire for that. You should have a desire to do something for your country. He put him in karma yoga because he wanted to do God realization. And he said, Bengali mein usko bola, ki itta selfish banne ki kya zarurat hai tujhe? Can you believe that? How? You know, unhone dusra hi angle le liya. But obviously, by doing what he did, he was going on a spiritual path anyway by helping other people. So that was a very interesting point that you brought. I just saw that 2 days ago. I saw that movie. Okay. So let's read now. Any other person wants to share anything about this concept? Okay. Who's the volunteer here to read? One of you have to read. Neeluji. Go ahead, Neeluji. Unmute yourself, please.
For him, there is no interest whatever in what is done or what is not done, nor does he depend upon any being for any object. An ordinary man is whipped into action either because of his anxiety to gain a profit or because of his fear that by not doing work he will be incurring a loss. But an individual who has the subjective experience of the spiritual stature in him, who has therefore discovered an eternal satisfaction in his own self, and who has reached perfect contentment therein, will have no more action to perform. He has nothing more to gain through activity, nor can he have any fear of losing anything in the world due to non-performance of any action. Such an individual, rooted in the experience of the self and depending upon nothing, neither any being nor any object, for his joy and bliss, has discovered the subject within. The objects of the world, in any case, are essentially nothing other than the subject being tossed on the waves of agitations in the mind.
So it's a pretty simple, you know, after we discussed everything, that he has no anxiety to gain any profit, or if he doesn't do any work, he doesn't have any anxiety to lose anything, you know. And then the last part is a very important one, where he says that he has discovered the subject. Yeah, subject means, you know, like the reality, God, consciousness, all these words are synonyms. And what is the subject itself is the objects of the world, you know, being tossed in the waves of agitation in the mind. So it's like ocean and waves. You know, waves are nothing but agitations of the ocean. But as a whole, the ocean says, what agitation? It's just me only. This little wind came and the waves are coming. What's the big deal? You know, that's what it is. So he just realized the whole world is Bhagwan only. Mereko kya milega, kya nahi milega? Because that's why they say, na, किसी ने पूछा कि यू नो व्हाट इज योर फैमिली, इज माय होल वर्ल्ड इज माय फैमिली वसुधैव कुटुंबकम, यू नो, एंड आई स्लीप ऑन द ग्राउंड, दैट इज माय माय बिस्तर, एंड द आकाश इज माय कवर, यू नो, दैट्स हाउ दे लिव. एंड दे ट्रूली, आई मीन दिस इज नॉट सम, बिकॉज वी कम फ्रॉम इंडिया, वी नो दो साधुज एंड ऑल दैट हु हैव बिकम लाइक दैट, दे आर एंड दे आर टोटली हैप्पी, दे डोंट नीड एनी डॉक्टर, दे डोंट नीड नथिंग, यू नो, दे आर जस्ट लिविंग. Complete faith in God. God takes care of them. That's what it is. So this was a simple one, you know. So from this, whatever we read, anybody has any question or
question? Yeah, this I think this verse is actually talking about doing action consciously with material gain and spiritual action. That is karma. So here they want, my book has described this, material action is actually performed by engaging the life currents and the mind with the senses. And so that is called the material action. You're still doing your duty. And meditative action is you're withdrawing all your mind and your energy from the senses. So that's the difference between the physical action, material action, and the religious actions, spiritual actions.
True.
That's
true.
The difference between karyam and
So somebody was saying that why did Krishna Bhagwan say that we cannot live without action? Remember, there was a previously, if you remember, we came across that verse when he said that the reason you want to do karma yoga is because nobody can live without action. So for spiritual, ya to spiritual gain ke liye bhi humko action hi karna padta hai, right?
Yeah.
So action ke liye we cannot, and then हम लोग एक्शन बहुत सुपरफिशियली देखते हैं कि भाई ऊपर ऊपर से एक्शन देखा खाली फिजिकल है. नो, एक्शन हैज़ अ वेरी वेरी ह्यूज मेंटल कंपोनेंट, बिकॉज इफ यू डू इट करेक्टली द इम्प्रेशन, रिमेंबर वी नो द होल थिंग दैट इट डजंट क्रिएट इम्प्रेशन, बट इफ यू डू इट रॉन्गली एनी एक्शन कैन क्रिएट द इम्प्रेशन इन योर माइंड, एंड दैट इज अ मेंटल एक्शन हो गया, एंड देन इट कॉज बॉन्डेज. सो दैट्स वाई एक्शन इज हैज़ अ वेरी बिग इम्प्लीकेशन, you know. So, and like Vasneha was saying, so we have to do it at every stage, understanding the entire spectrum of action, you know. So that was a good point. Anybody else?
That action is a karma mode, actually.
Hmm?
That...
Yeah, the one who does, the self-realized person does in a karma mode, true. Yeah, and that's what we have to strive for.
Yeah, consequence nahi hota.
Right. So that's... तो उसकी स्लेट क्लीन ही है और क्लीन ही रहती है.
yeah.
और अगर हमने अकर्म मोड में नहीं किया तो हमारी वो डर्टी होती जाती है. ट्रू,
ये कॉज एंड इफेक्ट होता रहता है.
राइट, बिकॉज हम बॉन्डेज में रहते हैं ना, बिकॉज हम लोग हमेशा एक्सपेक्ट करते हैं रिजल्ट वगैरह, एक्सपेक्ट करते रहते हैं, तो फिर देन वी कीप्स बॉन्डेज बढ़ता जाता है. सो नाउ उसके बाद जो नेक्स्ट वर्ड्स है ना, इट्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग वर्ड्स, वर्स 19. That's almost like a Krishna Bhagwan ne usko bola ki bhai tu karma kar, tu you know karma yoga kar, fir unhone pura ye matlab yagna spirit ka discourse diya, bahut logically diya usko, yahan tak ye bhi bataya ki bhai ye aaya kahan se, ye bhagwan se aaya hai karma. And another way to look at karma is that when Bhagwan ne ye duniya ko chakra shuru kiya, so karma is like a doing, karma is almost like a gift given to humans, ability to act is like a gift given by God to humans, you know. So we should use, but Bhagwan ne sirf ek aur bhi cheez di, hum log ko freedom diya, main karu ya na karu, because like we have discussed, animals, they don't have that choice. Animals do karma yoga. वो karma yoga mode में उसमें उन्हें automation से करते हैं वो लोग karma yoga mode. Okay? हम लोग को उन्होंने choice दिया है तो इसलिए हम लोग lazy path ले लेते हैं and things like that. But that whole karma is, firstly remember that, that it, like we discussed earlier, that it has different aspects to it, you know, mental and physical and all that. And then sometimes what happens is in the world, somebody does some action, wrong action, okay? Suppose. इमीडिएट रिजल्ट लुक्स वेरी गुड. किसी ने झूठ बोला, चोरी की, कुछ किया, इमीडिएट रिजल्ट लग रहा है कि यू नो बेनिफिट मिल रहा है. एंड देन दैट पर्सन स्टार्ट थिंकिंग, ओ आई कैन डू रॉन्ग एक्शन एंड आई कैन गेट अवे विद इट बिकॉज एंड देन यू नो. बट देर इज़ नो फ्री लंच इन दिस वर्ल्ड. दैट्स वाई द लॉ ऑफ कर्मा इज सो टाइट. लाइक आवर टीचर यूज टू से देर इज़ नो मिस्टेक इन गॉड्स मैथ. यू नो लाइक किसी अकाउंटेंट को पूछो कि इफ ही हैज टू बैलेंस द शीट, यू नो बैलेंस शीट, वो जब तक वो 1 सेंट उसका वो अकाउंट नहीं कर देता, ही कैन नॉट क्लोज इट. यू नो एंड इट माई, यू नो इट माई टेक हिम 2 आवर्स, बट ही हैज टू सिट एंड फाइंड एंड बैलेंस इट. सेम वे दैट समबडी माई थिंक दैट यू नो, सो दैट्स नॉट ट्रू. सो दैट्स द अनदर रीजन दैट दीज लॉज ऑफ कर्मा आर जस्ट लाइक अ लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटी. Applies to the, all the universe, all the time, time, space, nothing matters. So same way. So just because aise dikh raha hai mujhe, that's just an illusion, you know. So we have to pay for everything that, you know, good or bad we do. That's why he wants us to act in the yagna spirit, because there is a whole system that when you act in yagna spirit, 2 things happen according to him, and which is very important, because see, one of the thing of Bhagavad Gita is it doesn't talk about only the spiritual gain. Side by side, you get material gain also. It's a prosperity. That's why the last verse of Bhagavad Gita is, hey, jahan par Krishna hai aur jahan par Arjuna hai, wahan prosperity bhi hogi, which is most amazing thing. Yani ki, or even, I mean, now we talked about Vivekananda, that was his goal. To get India out of this poverty, and you know, he was so disgusted with it. You know, his own family went through it. He went through when he had nothing to eat, and you know, he had to go beg to his friends and things like that, and his heart was crying. And he said, just Hindi mein bhi ek hai na ki bhuke pet na hoye Gopala. They say that. So Bhagavad Gita teaches you, hey, do in yagna spirit, create lot of rain in a sense. Lot of productivity, the entire community becomes prosper and you become prosper, because the entire community, you are part of it. So that's the most important thing that he's teaching Arjun, that yagna spirit mein kaam karne se you are helping the chakra, and you are jo bhi Bhagwan ne tumko gift diya hai karma karne ka, wo tum sahi dhang se karoge. Productivity badhegi, food is like, you know, all the different material gains that we get, and inside purity ho jayegi. I mean, what more can we ask for? Nothing. Like you, both ways you are. Nahi to bole ki okay, spiritual to mil gaya, mere ghar ka kya hoga? You know, or things like that. He's saying, no, you will get everything. Don't worry about it. So, and now the question is that your self-realized log hote hain. Why do they work? We have to work as a sense of duty still. We have to work in the yagna spirit still, because we are not there. That will purify us. Wo to purify ho gaye hain, to fir un log ka motivation kya hai? Motivation is joy. Motivation is compassion, wisdom, you know, an expression of love for them, you know. So that comes automatically to them. It's not a sense of duty, but all these other great things. And then we are trying to develop these things. So in this particular verse, it starts with the word therefore, tasmat. Sara logic de diya unhone. Ab bol rahe hain, therefore you should work. Ye nahi ki bhai Arjun get up and fight. To Arjun bolega bhai kyun, right? Sara logic diya unhone. So what one of the swamis put it very carefully, he said, look, Bhagavad Gita appeals to your intellect. Bhagavad Gita is not some emotional type of thing, or you know, have faith in me, Bhagwan ko mano, ye karo, wo karo. No. It's telling you the entire science and logic so that your intellect connects with it. Because the way he was explaining that if your mind only connects and emotions only connect, na? Emotion needs constant food. You know, or emotion ko jise wana kisi puppy or forget about puppy, you know, there are some people, you know, you keep, oh, by praising them and giving them a little, then they will do. The moment you stop doing that, they'll stop. You know? So, but if somebody gets intellectually convinced that this is the right thing to do, rain or shine, I have to do this. Somebody gives me a praise or not praise, I don't care. That's when you will do it at all points. So that's what he's trying to teach him, that look, Bhagavad Gita mein Krishna Bhagwan ne usko aise nahi bol diya ki jaake fight kar. Usne pura logic diya usko. Chalu kiya chapter 2 se. Chapter 3 mein he talked about the whole logic of Yagna spirit and what can happen if you don't do. Then your life goes in vain, you know, if you don't help in this chakra and all that. All that he gave. And wo Swami ne ye bhi bola ki agar logic achha hota hai na aur hamare intellect ko samajh mein aata hai to hum dushman ki baat bhi manenge. अगर दुश्मन भी हमको लॉजिकली कोई बोलेगा तो हम उसको भी मान लेंगे. तो इंटेलेक्ट को से मानना इतना इम्पोर्टेंट है, यू नो. और हमारे रिलीजन, मतलब हमारे सनातन धर्म में ये एक बहुत बड़ी खासियत है, दैट इट अपील्स टू अवर इंटेलेक्ट. एंड यू आर फ्रीडम टू आस्क क्वेश्चंस एंड यू आर फ्रीडम टू अंडरस्टैंड इट फ्रॉम योर इंटेलेक्ट, सो दैट यू it will become part of you, it will become, you know, every core of you, then nobody else can come and shake your mind, you know. So that this therefore word is so strong over here, you know, and then makes you independent, you know. Then you're not dependent, and that's how, because if journey is from dependence to independence, so this logic makes you independent. And so here he's gonna, let's do the verse and let's see the words, because there are some very, very important words in there that we need to pay attention to. This verse, this is a very loaded verse, because this is the conclusion he comes and tells Arjun to do now. So the verse is, tasmadasakta satatam karyam karma samachara asakta hyacharan karma परमान परमाप्नोति पुरुषः तस्मात्. सो तस्मात् इज देयर फॉर असक्त. एवरीबडी नोज असक्त मीन्स विदाउट अटैचमेंट, एंड वी हैव गॉन सो मेनी टाइम, यू नो, एंड वी विल गो लिटिल बिट मोर ओवर इट, व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इट मीन्स. सततम इज ऑलवेज. सो द इम्पोर्टेंट वर्ड वॉज देयर फॉर. एवरी वर्ड इज इम्पोर्टेंट इन दिस. असक्त मीन्स विदाउट अटैचमेंट. सततम मीन्स ऑलवेज, मीन्स continuously. बोलते हैं ना सतत कार करो, हमेशा, means keep doing a karma yoga सततम. कि किसी ने बोला कि चिन्मयानंद जी को किसी ने पूछा, वो ड्यूटी कब तक करनी होती है? 24/7, you know 24 घंटे. इट्स लाइक आई वॉज थिंकिंग अबाउट इट, इट्स लाइक अ मदर, न्यू मदर, ओके, बेबी इज बॉर्न, उसको बोले कि हाउ मेनी आवर्स यू वॉन्ट बी अ मदर, हेलो, यू नो, इट्स लाइक. So that's what it is, satatam, okay? Or father also, we have men here too, same thing. You know, these days it's equal. Karyam here has a very deep meaning. Which should be done, not just any amai koi karya. Karya here means your obligatory duty. Remember that niyatam karma, we have hashed it out so much. Duty to your body, duty to your family, duty to your community, duty to your nation, and duty to your nature, duty to the universe. That's his karyam over here. That means satatam karyam. You do 24 hours this for duties. Karma, we know action. Samachara, this is a loaded word. Yeah, the meaning only is giving perform. That's a very simple meaning, but samachara, samyak achara, they call it. Efficiently, perfectly means chitna tum achha kar sakte ho. So this was the hallmark of Swami Chinmayananji, that he did everything in samachara. You know, if he's talking to a little boy, he will give full attention to that little boy. If talking to whoever, and you know, like somebody said that in those days there was no email, no nothing, so he used to people used to write letters. That's the only way he could communicate in the whole world. Couple of hours of letters he had to do. They said, even though he would write it so neatly, fold it like a perfection, put the stamp bhi teda nahi hota tha unka. Matlab, jo, that's called samachara, means doing it efficiently, beautifully, perfectly, and that's what it is. So That's that word. Samacharan is very important. Asakta is, again, we know, without attachment. Acharan is performing. Karma is action again. Parama is supreme, means that takes you to supreme, and we will go over these words. Apnoti, you know, to get something, attain. Purusha is man. Man here means Arjun. Man here means he's addressing all of us. So now let's kind of analyze some of the words, some of them I already did. Karyam, we understood that this is obligatory duty. And we should know that if you're talking about the chakra, this obligatory duty, these different aspects depend upon everybody. Family depend on each other. Community depend on each other. The nature depend. And if you don't take care of nature, you know what can happen. It is happening right now. So that's what it is. It's like a dependency that we have to fulfill our thing. And then what happens now? Let's see the psychology. If somebody does what Krishna Bhagwan is saying, and here one of the most important thing is it has to be satatam, constantly. Karyam, obligatory duty. Samachara, do it with like a perfection in as far as you are concerned. From your perspective, it should be. You know, somebody else, कोई और तुम्हारे को निंदा भी करेगा, लेकिन अगर तुमने अपना बेस्ट किया, that's what he's asking for over here. Not like perfection in that sense, and don't take it wrong. You know, the best that you can, because sometimes, you know, हम लोग half heartedly करते हैं, हम लोग को मालूम होता है जब हम half heartedly काम करते हैं. So, I know I didn't put my best. I can do better. Some people can catch you too. Your family can, you know. आज खाना अच्छा नहीं बना है. You are capable of better. Anyway, so. लेकिन ये सब ऐसा सब असक्त होके करो. दैट्स वॉट इज द थिंग. द बिगेस्ट लोडेड वर्ड ओवर हियर इज डोंट गेट अटैच टू द एक्शन, डोंट गेट अटैच टू द पीपल, एंड डोंट गेट अटैच टू एनीथिंग व्हाइल डूइंग दैट. स्पेशली नॉट टू द रिजल्ट ऑफ द एक्शन. ओ आई एम डूइंग, मैंने अच्छा खाना इसलिए बनाया कि सब लोग आज बोलेंगे वाह वाह, मैं सबके चेहरे ही देखती जा रही हूँ बार बार, कब मुझे वो मेरे को प्रेज करेंगे और समथिंग लाइक दैट. नो. So what he's saying that if you do it without attachment, if you do it constantly, if you do it like this, a joy start bubbling in your heart. You enjoy the work. That's where he's trying to get Arjun to the state. That you know, result aaye nahi aaye, tumko concern hi nahi hai. Because tum apna job itna achha kar rahe ho. And, you know, right now I'm jumping the gun a little bit, but it is important. That because sometimes you say, how can there be job, how can I be feel happy? Bhagavad Gita actually gives you an entire spectrum of how to do job that will make you happy. And that will come much, much later, will keep coming, because he's going to tell you about the sattva guna, sattva, rajas and tamas gunas, with makeup of mind. What is your makeup of mind? What is more conducive? Your work. That work, if you do, you get the joy. All of us have to find, it's like one of the Swamis put it very good. He's saying it's like you buy a cloth from the market, especially women. They go to India and they get some ready-made dress, and then wo darji baithe hote hain bahar, custom design karte hain. You know, they fit you, the stuff to you, so that look good. So he's saying the God has given you this body. Now you have to custom design this body. You know, that, hey, what is it good for? Like, what kind of work will be according to my swabhava? That when I do it, I'll do it with joy. So all that will come later. But over here, what we have to, and there are certain duties that comes from maturity. You know, that, hey, I like to do this particular job, but there are things that I may not want to do, but it's necessary for me to do it. And main usko bhi haste haste kar rahi hu. You know, apna bhajan gaate hue main kar rahi hu, then you start getting joy in that too. You become like automatic. So that's what he's saying, that when you do the work properly, it will start giving you joy and peace. And one of them even went as far as saying, suppose it doesn't give you joy, usko bhi chhod do tum, but it will give you peace. And that's what that peace is going to keep purifying your mind, and then it will keep you in that present mode. Because you are not focused on the result. Result aaye nahi aaye, chinta hi. Jab mereko abhi joy mil raha hai, to main aage ki joy ka sochungi nahi. you know. And I remember that there was this one fellow in Houston, you know, one of our friends. I mean, he was very successful in his business, and he had earned a whole lot of money, you know, and all that. And then one time we were talking to him and say, oh, we're planning on vacation. We had gone together one time on a cruise. And he said, you know, actually going on a cruise, that's the final thing that happens. But jab koi plan karta hai, usme bhi joy hota hai, wo bola. And that's a very important part of it. Guy jaye, nahi jaye, lekin plan kar, oh, main aisa karo. That's also great. So he's saying you should enjoy the whole process. So he, I don't know whether he had studied Bhagavad Gita or not, but he got the right idea. Perfect. That's what they are telling you, that just enjoy the ride and you got it made. You know, so this is what this verse is kind of bringing us back to, you know. So let's see if there's any other. Samachara, I already told you about what it is. Yeah, I think I covered most of it. Asakta, I did. Yeah, one example is that, you know, when we look at animal kingdom, especially the ants and the spiders, yeah, Houston, I mean, sorry, Houston, what do you, San Diego, mein do cheeze bahut saari hai. Sabhi log observe karte hai, ant, spider. और एक स्पाइडर वेब ऐसे बनाया था मेरी खिड़की के या मतलब वेयर फ्रॉम वेयर आई यूज्ड टू लाई डाउन एंड लाइक आई डिडंट लेट देम ब्रेक इट बिकॉज़ आई वांटेड टू ऑब्जर्व दैट. तो वो रोज है ना हवा से वो हट जाता था बिकॉज आई लिव नियर द ओशन सो देयर इज लॉट ऑफ विंड दैट कम्स. एवरी डे नया वो बनाती थी वो. एंड यू नो माय सन स्टार्टेड कॉलिंग मी योर फ्रेंड इज देयर. It was so much joy just to watch. I said, kabhi thakti nahi hai ye. And the Swami was saying that you know, like he said that one time he saw these ants was taking some other dead animal or something they were carrying. You know, ants can carry a lot of weight. And they're going uphill. And then that whole thing fell. And very nicely they went back and started doing again. ये नहीं कि ओ माई गॉड मेरा सारा वेस्ट हो गया अब मैं करूँगी नहीं. जैसे ह्यूमन लोग शुरू कर देते हैं ना. Nothing, joyfully taking again 2-3 times, you know, 5 times. So he's saying that that's what we should get the, you know, inspiration from. Look at the animal kingdom and you will realize what this verse is saying, you know, all the aspects of it. I thought that was so beautiful. And actually it happened, you know, it just, and this, whatever I'm telling you, I think it was last year that I saw that Makkani doing all that, you know. So the result will be that our mind will get pure and then we will eventually reach the goal. That's what he's talking about in this. They keep doing this karma yoga in such a way.